फ्रेंड्स, दिस इज अक्षय एंड वेलकम टू योर ऑन दिस चैनल ऑफ करियर एज। सो आई एम हियर विद द रिव्यू ऑफ वीक वन ऑफ डेटा एनालिटिक्स कोर्स, अ प्रोफेशनल सर्टिफिकेट कोर्स फ्रॉम कोर्सेरा एंड ऑल्सो फ्रॉम गूगल। सो दिस डेटा एनालिटिक्स प्रोफेशनल सर्टिफिकेट कंसिस्ट ऑफ 8 कोर्सेज एंड दिस इज द फर्स्ट कोर्स, दैट इज फाउंडेशंस डेटा एवरीवेयर। एंड आई कंप्लीटेड week 1, week 2 and I am doing week 3. So after completing all of these, I am making this review so that you have a better knowledge what is going to happen in this week, and also if you doesn't have a time to go through the materials, which is takes 5 hours to 6 hours, so that you can just listen my videos of reviews of all the weeks of this type of courses and go for the quizzes and complete that. And also many of you demanding for the answers of this Coursera course of Google career certificates, but I'm not going to give you all the answers. I completed all the quizzes with maximum marks, but I'm not going to give you the answers because this is this affects my channel, and also maybe Google issue copyright for my video. So here I am going to discuss all the questions which is in the quizzes of the week 1 or a week 2 or a week 3 in this type of videos itself. So if you want the answer, so you need to only listen my video only. There is a benefit to you that when you listen my videos, you also have an idea of all the contents, and also you got answers of quizzes. So I think this is a better idea. So I just prepared a notes of some pages after completing week 1, week 2 and start doing week 3. So I am just going to share this type of notes with you, and also maybe when you go through the link in the description, you find the PDF in PDF format, the notes which I made also. So I am going to start with the notes, not going to waste your time more and more in the introduction. So this is the course 1 and week 1 where you are mostly going to be introduced about this course. So here the week 1 is a start with a quote of Sherlock Holmes, which is data, I can't make bricks without clay. So you can just relate this with data and analytics, because without data you can't analyze that. So firstly you need data for analysis. So here it is the importance that you can't make bricks without clay. That's the thing, that you can't analyze data without you having data. So that's the thing. So what is data is? So data is a collection of facts. Okay, a very short definition, data is a collection of facts. So what is analysis? So through analysis you can make prediction, draw conclusions and decisions. So firstly you know data, second is analysis. So what make success in data analytics field? If you have a data, if you know analytics, then what is the chances of success, and what are the required components to be succeed? So these are the, firstly you need a computer where you take all the analytics jobs. After that, second is, and the most important things, total 4 components are there. First is computer, second is your brain, this is the most important thing. Next is your skills, what you have experience in data analytics field. The more you are doing analytics with different type of data, most you have experience. Next is your traits. So total 4 components which I explained. Next is what is need to make a decision in data analytics field. What are the components in which we need to think about that for going to make any decisions in data analytics, or what are the processes in data analytics. So this is the most important thing, and it is going to be used from course 1 to from week 1 to the last course 8 and at the last week. So you need to remember total 6 steps are there in data analytics. So these steps are ask, prepare, process, analyze, share and add. Total 6 things are there. And also I'm not going to define it here, because you find different type of definition as you begin this course, and as you completing one course then the definition changes. Then if you completed one more course then definition changes. So I am not going to define here in this video, I am going to define itself. So next is transforming data into insights. How to transform data into insights? This is mostly in the context context of business, how any business, why any business needs data, and what are the jobs from data with their data. So what why business needs data is to improve processes, identify opportunities and trends. Next is launch new products, and fourth is serve customers, and at the last make thoughtful decisions. So these are the five things for which business needs data. Next thing is, so here now there is a definition of data analysis. You need to be careful when you are listening data analysis and data analytics. Both are different things, and if you confuse, you may lose one number in your quiz. So means there is a question in the final quiz, and you need to be careful when you are attempting that, because there is an option of data analytics and data analysis both, and a collection, transformation and organization of data in order to draw conclusions, make predictions and drive informed decision making. So this is the definition of data analysis. Next is people analytics. When you discuss about data analysis, next thing is people analytics, which is when you apply data analytics on people, so that is called people analytics. And what is people analytics? It is the practice of collecting and analyzing data on the people who make up a company, a workforce, in order to gain insights to improve how the company operates. So this is a people analytics. Whenever any talk about the analytics and there are people or other the workforce is included, then there is a correct answer is people analytics. So next thing, now this is this six steps which I already defined. I only just defined their names. Now I am going to explain what is included in this six steps. You all know data analytics six step. You need to learn. If you doesn't know, please learn. So the first step is ask. If it is asked, so what is in this? What actual problem is and what would be the successful result? When we are in the first process, that is asked, means the first question you need to do is what is the actual problem is in this and what would be the successful result in the first. Next is prepare. So in the prepare, you plan and choose what to do. Next thing is process. In this, data would be collected, stored, managed and protected. So this is a very important, not very important, important step. And one thing you need to be careful in process, that is called data cleaning. Data cleaning is data must be complete, correct, relevant, erroneous and outliers. So this is the thing of data cleaning, and may you get a question on data cleaning on at the quiz. So next thing is analyze. Analyze, discover, analyze and document it. This is the main process, very important process of analyze. So we go through the first six steps, and only one step is included where you need to do analysis, and you need to go through all the steps, all other five steps. So the fourth step is analyze, and this is the most important step. Discover, analysis and document it. Next thing is share. Sharing the report and communicate results. Who give you that job to do data analytics job, data analysis job? So you need to communicate your result with them. Next thing is act. Implement and take changes. After getting data, going through analytics with the data, the changes which is you think that need to be made, now you share that results with them who urge you to do that data analytics, and they implement that on their workforce or on their job. So that is called act. Next thing is, now many of you confused with data science and data analytics, and many of you doesn't know what is data science is, what is data analytics is. So both are different things. In data science, there is the three things which comes. First is machine learning, second is statistics, and third is analytics. So all the three are different, and the jobs in all the three is also different. So I start with the first one, that is statistics. Statistics, making few decisions under uncertainty. And those whose mind is philosopher types and also just like epistemologists are mainly dealing statistics, and they need to be work on few they work on very few decisions, and they need to they have also very few data, and they need to make from their decision from that data only. Next thing is machine learning. Machine learning is very trending nowadays. You all know about that. And this is a part of artificial intelligence. So this is also make this more important. But in machine learning, many decisions under uncertainty. Next, and in machine learning, performance is the excellence. So if you are doing machine learning and you need to explore the machine learning field, then you need to be a very good performance. It needs very good performance. So at the last, there is a process of analytics. And what is in analytics is you doesn't know how many decisions you want to make before you begin. So you have a data, but you doesn't know what decisions and how many decisions you need to make with that data. So in the analytics field, the men, the women who are quick decision makers are needed, so that they make frequent changes in that specific field. So next thing is which comes data ecosystem. Data ecosystem, in the world, you think that data ecosystem is a data and all around the data is ecosystem, because when we say about environment and ecosystem, then it applied that ecosystem, all things which is in our surrounding. So in data ecosystem, the definition changes. How I'm going to convey with you the various elements that interact with one another in order to produce, manage, store, organize, analyze, and share data. It is called data ecosystem. So you need to be very careful. This one definition is also going to be asked in the final quiz of this Google Career Certificates week 1. So next thing is cloud. What is cloud? We all know that cloud is very important. In our mobile to our laptops, we store our data in cloud. If we don't directly upload our data, but there is many ways where cloud is related to all of us. Just like when we do messages on social media and we just log out, but when we go once more after login, then we get the same messages because that data is stored in somewhere. So that is cloud, means your data is online and it is stored in somewhere. So that this is all about cloud, and it is more important in the data analytics field. So what is a cloud? A simple definition is a place to keep data online rather than a computer hard drive. It plays an important role in data ecosystem. So that's all about cloud. Now we are going to learn about data science, which I explained you in beginning that data science is different, data analytics is different. So how they are different, now I'm going to explain that. So data science is creating new ways of modeling and understanding the unknowns by using raw data. This is called data science. I already explained data analytics. This is a data science, means creating new ways of modeling and understanding the unknowns by using raw data. Next thing is, what is now difference between data science and data analytics? So data analyst. So now what are the difference? Data scientists create new questions using data, while analysts find answers to the existing question by creating insights from data sources. So now you get the difference between data scientists and data analysts. So now we jump to the next portion that is very important. Firstly, I am going to explain what data ecosystem and data analysis all are comes in the field of data analytics. Data analyst, data analysis, data and data ecosystem, all the three are part of data analytics. So now we are going to jump on a very important topic, from where total 3 or 4 questions are there in your quiz. So that is data driven ecosystem, data driven decision making. On what is data driven decision making? Using facts to guide business strategy, figuring out the business need, and also it includes insights from people who are familiar with the business problem. So this is very important. All the three lines are very important. You need to be go through once more from this line. I am just repeating. Your data driven decision making is using facts to guide business strategy wherever business and marketing is related, and wherever it is asked questions about market and the business, then there is, if there is the option of data driven decision making, you need to choose that. So in this, what is there? Figuring out the business need, include insights from people who are familiar with the business problem. So where in this, the next thing come is subject matter expert. When you have a data and you are going to analyze that, then there is some problem that maybe you doesn't know more about that. Maybe your understanding about that data is very much, but about that topic is not, doesn't have a very much knowledge about that topic which you analyzing. So if you contact subject matter experts, then they may give you some advice, so that your decision, your result may be more effective. So what is subject matter experts are? They have the ability to look at the results of data analysis and identify any inconsistencies, make sense of gray areas, and eventually validate choices being made. So what the purpose of subject matter expert is, there is a gap between data and the data analysis result. So the gap between data and data analysis is going to be filled by subject matter experts. So you need to be aware about this, and also there is a question about subject matter expert also in the final quiz. So now I'm going to just convey that no matter how valuable data-driven decision making is, data alone will never be the as powerful as data combined with the human experience and also observation and sometimes even intuition. So you need to be careful about that also. Next thing is examples of this data-driven decision making. There is a one question with this also, and the most important examples I am going to give you, there are two examples. First is music streaming services, just like Spotify and other music streaming services. What they do, when you listen one song, second song on that platform, after that they suggest you a playlist which is recommended by them because of your searching data and also the music which you listened before. So this is whole about data driven decision making, and also because of that you go back on that music streaming services, and now you think that your favorite musics are there, so you go back, and this make them more earn more and more through ads. So this is all about music streaming services. Next thing is e-commerce. You all know, before 15 years, there is no space of e-commerce in our markets. But today, mainly e-commerce is in the comparison with physical shops and different type of activities which we do in physical form. Because e-commerce is a boost. The data analyst observed that there is a gap between physically going to the market, and there is lots of efforts we need to do. So they make a plan to give your products on your doorstep, and this make a revolution. And you can see that Amazon, a tech giant, how they revolutionize this type of e-commerce type of things. Okay, so this is a good very important steps, very important examples of data driven decision making. Next thing is we all know, I already explained all the 6 points. Now there is one more examples or one more definitions of that, all the six processes which I already explained. What that all the six are, I am going to firstly name them, and also say a simple definition about that. So firstly, there is a process of ask in data analysis process, and in ask you need to you get business challenge, objective, and question. Next thing is prepare. In this you need to generate data collection, storage, and data management is there. In the process, data cleaning is here and data integrity is there. In the fourth, there is a process of analyze, and there data exploration, visualization, and analysis is there. Next thing is share, communicating and interpreting the results, and at the last there is act, and the last step there is putting your insights to work to solve the problem. So these are the six steps, and I define them, and you need to be go through all the six steps one and listen all the six steps once again, because there is two or three questions about only these six steps in your final quiz. So at the last, very few things are remain, so I'm going to explain them also. There is a called gut instinct, and gut instinct is an intuitive understanding of something with little or no explanation. So this is a gut instinct, and also there is a one question about gut instinct also in the final quiz. So making decision based on your gut instinct without any data to back it up, it can lead to mistake. So mainly data analyst doesn't do this type of things. The gut instinct is mainly done by investigators who investigate any cases or other things. So next thing is, what make a successful data analyst? First is data, and second is your business knowledge, which makes a success in data analyst process if we talk about data driven decision making. Next thing, this is a very important, and this is the last thing in this, and at the last there is also a data evolution, how data analysis process is evolved from time by time, and now at the last I am going to explain that that portion is not included in quizzes, so you doesn't need to be worry about that. And the last thing which is important is, successful analysis needs to be accurate and fast enough to help decision makers. So try asking these questions about a project. So which type of questions you need to ask when you are dealing with data analysis process? So the first question is, what kind of results are needed? Next question is, who will be informed? The third question is, am I answering the question being asked? And at the last, the question is, how quickly does a decision need to be made? So this is the whole four question which need to be asked when you're doing data analysis process, and these all four questions are very important. And at the last, I'm going to just give you some tips that if there is any question related to marketing, then you just choose data driven decision making. If anything which is related to something which is matter experts is there, and means you need to go through the go through that topic in the deep knowledge, so that is the thing where subject matter experts are needed. And if this type of questions are asked, then you choose subject matter experts. And also there is a thing, the data evolution, data analysis process evolution. So what is data analysis process evolution is, we go through the many evolutions in data analysis, and the first result which we get is the construction of pyramid in Egypt. So mainly the construction of pyramid in Egypt is based on data analysis, and also from there we have many examples where the data analysis process is evolutionized, and also many other companies also use data analysis process with different type of terms, but the most important is data analyst process, which is six process I explained in this. And also different companies have different type of words for their data analyst thinking. So you doesn't need to be go through that. Also many other companies which have their data but doesn't go through that. And this is a whole about the week one of the data analyst career certificate of the first course, foundations data analyst. And this is the whole review, and if you listen the whole review, you must all the things which I explained in this video, you must pass the final examination without going through any contents and anything. And also there is a PDF link in the description, you go through that and just download that, and take with you when you are attempting the quiz. And I think that helps you to get more and more score in your final quiz of the week one. So I am back with the week two review, and if you like this video, please share with your friends also, and also subscribe my channel so that it motivates me to make all the reviews for all the weeks. So that's much in this video. Thanks for watching.